We took the, language discrimination to the Human Rights Commission.
Just getting my, I can hear you, I'm just getting my cup, sorry. Yeah, carry on, sorry about that.
Brandy, right?
Sorry. Yeah, this is, good year.
No, we took the language discrimination to the Human Rights Commission, they wouldn't even touch it.
Yeah, they wouldn't.
I think we got to discovery and that was about it.
I'm amazed you got that far.
Yeah.
Because you go there as, the Christians, the son, said to me, should we go to Human Rights Commission? I said, well, they won't hear it, but I wouldn't even use it. I wouldn't legitimize them by going there. But no, they're very choosy.
Very, very choosy. So anyway, the IMANs came out today, or yes, in today's paper, saying that violence to women and the families and honor killings should be discouraged. Are they just saying that?
Oh, I don't know which imams these were. How many and who were they?
Like they say across the country.
Three.
Well, there's no such thing because unlike, say, Catholicism, Islam has no central authority. And I've met many Muslim leaders in Ontario. They're not liberal. I mean, I think there are Islamic leaders who are opposed to honor killings. Without any doubt, there are. And even to domestic violence, but there are others who won't comment on it. But I'd say the majority would say no to honor killings. But that should be a self-evident truth. It's against the law.
Yeah.
Ask them where they stand on polygamy. Ask them where they stand on conversion. Ask a Muslim leader who say condemns honor killings. What should happen to a Muslim who becomes a Christian? And they'll lie to you.
Yeah.
Because in Islam, you are to die. And they can't say that because it sounds so bad, because it is so bad, but that is actually the truth. That I wouldn't want my children to embrace another religion. I would be upset. There are Jewish people at its most intense who will say, you are dead to me, which I think is awful, but they will say that. That's not many. But again, this is a different world from saying, we will kill you.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And that Islam believes that to be an apostate is to die. You can be another religion, but if you leave Islam, you will die. That is Islamic teaching. It's one of the reasons why there are so few people who embrace other faiths in the Islamic world, or leave when they do, because they're not allowed to. But if they do, they have to be very secret about it.
Or even now.
And there was a gentleman...
I just want to say that these women that follow their... in Islam, they follow their husband. This husband was walking, he had four wives walking behind him, and they were asked, why do you walk five paces behind your husband? He said, landmines.
Being British, I thought that joke was going to have the word fart in it. Somewhere. Right. Apparently my time... Now, can they have 5 minutes to buy the books before I go?
Oh, they can. That's much time as they want.
Well, you want another
seat. Oh, when are you leaving?
Well, I can leave for a quick...
Take a 2 minute break.
Oh.
We're going to take a 2 minute break, or maybe five. So, if you want to buy books, you can. Look, I have heard what you've had to say. I'm not just going to drive off now and forget it. Because honestly, I admit my failings. I wasn't aware this was such an issue. I knew it was an issue. I didn't know it was such an issue. The anger and the pain here, I have not let it just slide off my back. So, I've got your card with your real phone number. I'm going to make sure that even before the new year, actually, probably maybe... next week or the week after, we get you or someone on to talk about this issue.
Good.
In fact, you know what we can probably... Could you be in... So we can do it from Ottawa. I mean, it's better if we're in the studio.
But you can go to Toronto, no problem. Anytime.
Hey, could you be in Toronto next week?
Yep.
Yep.
What's a good day for you? Because I've got a couple of spaces open.
Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, or Friday.
And I'm going to do you all justice.
Okay, the most important thing, who is the 25-year-old girl you're bringing with you?
Some girlfriend.
All right.
My son's girlfriend's 25. She's gorgeous. She's a law student, and you'll like her.
Yes. I'm married, man. I will, on Monday, my producer will contact you and fix up the actual day. Now, we'll be on for 7 to 8 minutes. That's how long a segment is. Don't bash me up because you don't have the whole show.
Okay.
You've got to remember, who do we have on next week? We have an Egyptian Christian leader who's just come back from Iraq. We have Peter Brimelow talking about immigration. We have, but these are important issues. That doesn't mean that's the last time you're on. It means it's the first time you're on.
That's not long.
It goes well. No. That's how long you get. Yeah. Say thank you. Not that long. That's not long. That's not long.
Michael.